Hello everybody, I am Hannah, an English teacher at Virtually Fluent, and in this video today, we're going to learn how to give personal information. Today, we are going to learn how to give 8 important pieces of personal information. Your name, your job, your age, your country, where you live, so your address, your telephone number, and your email address. This is important information that you might need for travel if you reserve tickets, for business if you want to introduce yourself to somebody, or in general, for providing personal information. So this is really important information in English. Let's look at each of these 8 important things individually, and we'll start with your name. These are the typical questions that you might ask about somebody's name. What is your name? What is your name? What are you called? What are you called? To respond to these questions, we can say, my name is, I am called, or I am. And then here you put your name. I can say, my name is Hannah. My name is. My name is, I am called, I am called, I am. This is my name, Hannah Wilkinson. Hannah is my first name, and Wilkinson is my surname or family name. In English-speaking countries, most people only have one surname, which I know is different in other countries. Most people also have a middle name. My middle name is Ruth. This is used on official documents, but normally people don't tell you what their middle name is. Let's return to this important question. When somebody asks me this question, normally I respond with my first name. But we can change this question to ask for more specific information. For example, what is your surname? My surname is Wilkinson. Or what is your middle name? My middle name is Ruth. Or you can ask for somebody's entire name. What is your full name? My full name is Hannah Ruth Wilkinson. Now let's talk about our age. There is only one question to ask about age. How old are you? How old are you? The response is, I am blah years old. Here we say the number for our age. To review all the numbers from 1 to 100, take a look at our previous video in this beginner's English series. I am years old. I am years old. I can say I am 26 years old. Be careful with this question because in English we use the verb to be. In lots of other languages you use the verb to have. This is incorrect. Even some of my advanced students make this mistake. The correct sentence is I am 26 years old. The next piece of personal information is your job, and these are the typical questions to ask about a job. What is your job? What is your job? What do you do? What do you do? To respond to this question, we say I am a and then the title of your job. I am a. I am a. I can say I am a teacher. You can use a dictionary or a translator to find your job title in English. But let's look at this example. I am an engineer. Now you can see that a has changed to an. This is because engineer starts with a vowel, E. If your job starts with a vowel, like engineer, then you say I am an instead. This is a special grammar rule in English, and we will review this in a later video. Now let's talk about your country. There are lots of questions to ask about a country. Where do you come from? Where do you come from? Where are you from? Where are you from? Which country are you from? Which country are you from? The response to all of these questions is I am from, and then the name of your country. Again, use a dictionary or a translator to find your country in English. I am from. I am from. I can say I am from England. There is one typical question to ask where somebody lives. Where do you live? Where do you live? The answer is I live in, and then the name of your country, city or town. I live in. I live in. If I answer this question, I can say I live in England for my country. But I can also respond with my city. I live in Winchester. When we ask about somebody's address, there is one typical question. What is your address? What is your address? To respond, we say my address is, and then your address. My address is. My address is. In the United Kingdom, this is the typical structure of an address. The first line is the name of the house. The second line is the number of the house and the street. The third line is the city. The fourth line is the county, so the region. And the final line is the postcode, which is a combination of letters and numbers. Of course, your address will be different if you don't live in the UK. So you use your own address. Remember to change numbers to English. Somebody might want to ask you a more specific question. For example, about your postcode. What's your postcode? In this example, the postcode is AB12CD. If you want to know the telephone number, you can ask these questions. What is your number? What is your number? What is your phone number? What is your phone number? What is your telephone number? What is your telephone number? To respond, we can use these sentences. My number is. My number is. My phone number is. My phone number is. My telephone number is. My telephone number is. And after these structures, we insert our telephone number. This is an example telephone number. In English, we read every number individually. So it's really important that you remember the numbers between 1 and 10 in English. To review these, you can see a previous video in our Beginner's English course on YouTube. This example is, my number is 01234567890. In the UK, all phone numbers are 11 numbers long. The first number is 0, but you will hear me say O instead. When we say a telephone number in English, we normally say O instead of 0. 01234567890. Some other useful vocabulary for a telephone number is double. This means we have two of the same number next to each other. For example, 01234567889. And the last important piece of information is your email address. This is the typical question. What is your email address? What is your email address? This is the response. My email address is, my email address is, and of course, after this expression, you insert your email address. Let's review some important vocabulary for email addresses. At, dot, dash, underscore, forward slash. We normally read all the whole words in an email address in English. Some typical endings for email addresses are .com, .org, and in the United Kingdom, .co.uk. My email address at the company is admin@virtually-fluent.com. So now we've learnt how to give all our personal information in English. Now you should know the questions and the answers. So let's practice. In the comments below, I want you to answer these questions. Please be careful with your personal information. Do not write your address, your email address, or your telephone number. I will be correcting any sentences in the comments below, so if you want some free English feedback from a teacher, then participate. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel and turn notifications on to see all the videos we upload on a weekly basis. In the next video, we'll review the correct structure of a sentence in English. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. I post lots of free content on a daily basis to help you learn and improve your English. This is Hannah at Virtually Fluent, bringing English to life.